Ani Bojo, Sego Tonse Kwe Kwe Kinawea. I bring greetings in the language of my ancestors, and I am very honored to be here this morning. I was given tobacco to speak in a good way with a good heart and a good mind. And as we heard, we're on traditional and treaty territory. The Mississaugas of the Credit are still here. They still conduct ceremony, and it's my honor to stand in acknowledgement of who they are, what they continue to do, and our beautiful relationship that we continue to nurture together. Mishke Dodem, Shuden Nigan Mawaswanan Edition Kamas, Shawanagan Dunji, Havlok Dunjabad Ishinabe Kwe, Ojibwe Murwan Miandao. I speak in the language of my Anishinaabe ancestors. I do indeed identify as Ojibwe and Potawatomi. And in sharing who I am in the language, I'm inviting spirit to come sit with us today. Because I want to remind you that you are a spiritual being having a physical experience, and not a physical being having a spiritual experience. So every day, every way, walk your truth, live your truth, honor who you are. So when we start in that good way, I already smudged in preparation for this opportunity to speak to each and every one of you. But I want to offer a more widespread smudge and perhaps a cyber smudge for those who might be streaming in and, you know, paying attention to what's going on here. Thank you for doing that for those that are online. I am known as Grandmother Kim Wheatley, and I am an ancestral knowledge keeper and a ceremonialist. And I was taught that before we start anything, we have to acknowledge not only who we are and whose territory we're on, but we need to speak to the unseen world. We need to speak to our ancestors, not just mine, but all of ours, because we're all Indigenous from somewhere on the planet. And we all have a bloodline and a connection and a truth that travels through us. And how that travels through us is through the water. And as a long-time water walker, I always speak about the water and for the water and to the water and feel about the water, because that is the life force that connects us all. And so I brought up a little glass of water. And I acknowledge this. We have many, many words for water. And English is rather limiting. But we talk about Nunziabo, that universal water, Dodo Wabo, that beautiful breast water that feeds our babies, Musko Wabo, that beautiful cleansing that life givers experience every month. And then we also have Mede Wabo, that beautiful medicine water. When we speak to it in a good way, she is a living being. And she responds to our good words, our good thoughts. Everything that we do gets recorded in her forever memory. And this is a very powerful teaching that I received from Grandmother Josephine Mandabe Nabar, and I honor her and thank her for that. I thank her for reminding me that I am a life giver in this life walk, and that I have a responsibility to ensure that this beautiful sacred being knows that we love her, knows that we respect her, knows that we honor her in all those good ways. And she taught us a song that we sing for the water, and I'm going to offer that for you now. And as I sing this song and I connect to what I've been taught and how it makes me feel, I hope you'll take a moment to add your thoughts and your feelings. If you haven't drank water today, I know most of you like to put that caffeinated stuff as the first thing in your mouth, but it should be water. Before you do that, there's one simple thing that we can do to connect to her, and it's to offer some sort of gratitude. In our language, we're saying wedge. And the song that I'm going to sing says, water, we love you, water, we thank you, and water, we respect you. And it's a really important process for us. There's always time for prayer, and prayer can be done in lots of different ways. I'm not religious at all, but I am deeply spiritual. This is the water song. I'll sing it to the four cardinal directions to help you in your hearts and minds. Remember to think something, feel something, say something. If you know the song, you're welcome to sing it as well. Water, he's all good, he goes. Much for joining me in that. Now, as we get started, we have to remember that we have many relatives, not just our human relations. And it's so easy to get caught up in the human world with humans. But it's important to remember that we have other relatives. And on a daily basis, they are bearing witness to the words that we speak, the feelings that we hold, the emotions that we send out. And you have all of that happening every day, from the moment you open your eyes to the moment you close your eyes, and even while you're sleeping. You are constantly sending energy out and connecting to those that have gone on long before us, those that are here now, and those that will come long after us. So this cyclic kind of connection, this movement, is constant. It's never static for us. And so we need to be mindful. We need to be present. We need to remember where we came from. We need to remember that we are here now. And we need to remember that someone and some things are going to come after us. And so I want to take this time, at this time, to bring your hearts and minds together. I want you to listen from your heart space. And I want you to join me in thinking about all of the sands, the soils, the clays, the gravels, the rocks, the stone beams, and the mountains. These are the most ancient beings on earth. They are the ones that teach you about resilience. They are the ones that hold you up every day. They are the ones who open their arms to receive our bodies at the end of our life walk. They are the ones that we refer to as grandmothers and grandfathers. So maybe I'll shift your relationship today. The ground you walk on. You're walking on the bodies of our ancestors. We as Indigenous people, First Nations, Métis, Inuit, have been here for time immemorial. Thousands and thousands and thousands of years. Every grain of sand here is connected to our people. And so we are holding up essentially as well. So on this day, I invite you to join me in giving them beads and things, language. And then I want to draw your hearts and minds towards the second order of creation. Now, the second order of creation wraps their arms, their roots around those grandmothers and grandfathers. And we refer to them as all the grasses, the shrubs, the trees, the bushes, the hardwoods, the softwoods, the berries, the hanging fruits, and all of the medicines. When we think about those relatives, in the Western world, you call them the plant world. But they are so much more than that. They sacrifice on a daily basis for our well-being. They fill our bellies when we're hungry. They heal our bodies when we're not well. They protect us from the elements because our bodies are frail. And they provide endless beauty for our senses. And so I think it's really easy for people to think of them as living beings. And on this day, I invite you to join me in giving them greetings and thanks. I also want to draw your attention to the third order of creation. These are our elder brothers and sisters. These are the ones who are far more ancient than human beings. They have been here for even longer than we have. They are the ones we refer to as the swimmers, the crawlers, the flyers, the two-leggeds, the four-leggeds, those that live up in the sky world, and those that live beneath the earth. You might call it the animal world or the animal kingdom, but they are our elder brothers and sisters. They teach us about sacrifice. They give up their own family members so that we can have life. They provide companionship so that we don't feel lonely. They teach us how to raise our families and how to find medicines. They protect the medicines. They do all of this on a daily basis, whether we remember to give them grief. piece of things. And so on this day, I invite all of you to acknowledge our elder brothers and sisters in English. Now we get to the fourth order of creation. And when we think about that, we can find a place of belonging in that. Because that's where all the babies reside on the planet. And who are they? They're human beings. In all our shapes, sizes, colors, identities. The human family are the youngest on the planet. And we look at the, you know, our older siblings, not as siblings sometimes. We don't see them as relatives. And everything's us, us, us. Me, me, me. Give me, give me, give me. But I invite you on this stage. Remember, you are part of that circle of belonging and responsibility. Be kind to each other. Open your hearts and receive the gifts of those that have crossed your life path. Each person was given gifts and responsibilities. You are not here by accident, no matter what your parents may say. You're here with purpose. And in the sharing of the truth of who you are, you need to unpackage those gifts and share those with us in whatever way they are. Maybe you're a great smiler. Maybe you're a great artist. Maybe you're a good singer. Who knows? There's so much diversity in how we can express our gifts and share them. But they're only gifts if you share them. So remember to share openly, willingly, lovingly, with kindness, with respect for each other and all the beings that we walk the planet with. I invite you to remember the connections. I want you to kind of examine, and I like the topic of this, and borders, borders crossing. All the different types of borders we need to cross means we need to stretch what we think we know, you know, and really expand our mental birdcage to embrace more than we thought was possible. And through that, we can have this united walk together along, you know, this new word we're using, reconciliation. What does it mean? I have a hard time with that. But I have a very deep understanding about what it means to be a good human being in relationship to all the other beings who have just as much right to be here as we do. So as you enjoy the food today, as you drink the water, as you hear the words, as you embrace the songs, as you visually digest, you know, the artwork that's taking place at the back and the dialogues you'll have, remember to do that in a good way, with a good heart and a good mind. Be a true and full human being in all that you do. Be conscious of the impact you have to all beings around you. It's such an honor to be able to open in this good way. I'm going to light the smudge now. It's actually sweetgrass. And for those of you that are familiar with our medicines, we have four. Cedar, sage, sweetgrass, and tobacco. Each one of them has a role. That's a whole teaching in and of itself. And when we light these, we're opening the door between the physical and the spiritual world in a respectful way, in a kind way, in a good way. And so as I think about that, and I think about each and every one of you, I think about how we can come together in that good way. And I think about how lucky we are to have these beautiful medicines. Wingush, in my language, is the term that we use for this, wingush. It is the hair of our Earth Mother. And as it's braided together, like my hair today, it's a way of honoring ties, connections, ancestral harmony and balance, and body, mind, spirit, body, mind, spirit, body, mind, spirit. Those three strands can embrace that harmony and balance of who we are. So in all the words that I've spoken today, I hope that some have resonated with you. In all the seeds that I've planted today, I hope you can carry those away and grow your own garden of relationships. Awareness, presentness, gift. I hope that you will find a way to share that with others, but most importantly, honor that within yourself. I'm going to send these words out to all of creation now with a song. We have a messenger, and that messenger is known as Megazin. That's the eagle. And the eagle, it said, flies around on a daily basis all over creation, looking for those who still remember to speak those good words, to feel those good words, to honor who you are, where you come from, and leave something for those that will come after us. And so I hope you'll do that. I invite you to do that. I want you to know you're capable of doing that. So as I close this opening up, which is probably a longer opening than you're used to, I always have lots to say as I try to set the tone of engagement, as I try to honor those that came before us, and as I think about those that will come after us, will this door be open for them? I hope so. Will Will we see each other as part of the human family and not the physical house that we've arrived in? Will we remember that we are spiritual beings having a physical experience and not physical beings having a spiritual experience? I hope so. Hope in me is always reignited each time I get to bring our voices, our ancestral wisdom and knowledge to each and everyone who's present or who wanted to be here or who should have been here or who may be here long after I have spoken these words. That resonance will stick and stay. So I'm going to offer this song. And the words in the song say, I hear the eagle, I see the eagle, and I go with the eagle. Now, this is a symbolic connection, knowing that we can connect to all of creation, both on the planet and, of course, right out into the universe. Hence why we acknowledge all the different types of water, which is life. We are all part of that. It's been such a great honor to stand here before you and offer what's flowing through me on this day. And for those that are online, I hope those words have a place and space of meaning for you as well. I'm going to ask you to stand for this song. It is an honor song. And again, invite you to think, feel, emote, whatever it is that you want to send out to creation on this day based on the nudging perhaps I've offered, but also on your inner calling. What's rippling through you right now? What do you feel like you just want to put out into the world? Intent travels ahead of physical action. What you intend is what you will meet. So intend well. I have my helper, the Wheatley. We call it the drum in English, but you know what it's called? Sound of the heart. I'm going to connect our hearts now. To the seen and the unseen world that we might start off this day and continue in a good way. You ready?
Yeah.
Beijing. I know I'm counting my language. I really want to mess you up a little bit. Beijing. So Don't be afraid of your voice. You can do better. Basic, niche, slick.